Hi, it's Carrie. This week, during my lunch times, I've been going out and buying cheap art supplies that I could find in the local town. So I started off with classic children's paint, the type that you just add water to and it turns into paint. It's not watercolour. With the classic brush. I also got some Crayola crayons, everyone's favourite. A palette of watercolour, which as you can see was £1.50, and some brushes because actually my brushes are getting all crusty and old now. As you can see, these were also £1.50. Today I'm going to be using this, which cost me £1. I'm going to use it to colour one of the drawings that I did a few years ago now, but I never got round to using pencils on it, so I decided why not use paint. Now, I am using a cheap sketchbook which actually says suitable for pencil and crayon, but I figured I'd push my luck and try paints on it, considering 6, 7, probably 8-year-old me used watercolor pencils on it, and the page didn't turn out too bad. So let's get into I decided to do this video as you always see people like Super Ray Dizzle and Jazza doing videos with cheap art supplies, and they're extremely talented artists who manage to get decent works out of cheap supplies. But I not an amazing artist, and I was wondering whether someone of mediocre talent would be able to get good results. So here I am trying it out. Do have a small pot of water here. I think it's probably best that I take this page out of my sketchbook. As you've seen in the thumbnail, this is a hermit crab that I drew some time ago now. On the other side, I've got an attempt at a cartoon bird and a cat, which actually doesn't look too bad, other than the fact that it kind of looks like an alien with a third eye. But there we are. I was young. Now, let's see how these paints go. Small pot of water. I don't even know why I'm trying to use this brush, but we'll see. Let's try. Doesn't seem to want to do anything at the moment. Oh, there we go. It's starting to do something now. There we are, turning into a bit of a paste. Some of these bristles are longer than others, or is it just sinking back into the, is it just sinking back into the brush? It is. It's just sinking back into the handle of the brush itself. Honestly, I don't know how I ever used these as a kid. Let's just see how this actually works. Oh, that's actually very yellow. I don't know why I thought that would be a creamy orange. Okay, I should probably swatch these. Let's see. I'm probably annoying some people by not doing them in order, but I'm doing them the way that I want to. Oh, This brush is terrible. I'm not going to use it for any more than the swatches. Okay, that's very, that's like if a white skin tone was turned fluorescent. Let's try this one. I should really have some towel to wipe my brush off on. But for some reason, I don't care that much because they're so cheap. See this? Bubblegum pink. If anything will actually get off of the brush. Bubblegum pink. Okay, I'm going to go and get some kitchen towel and I will be back in a minute. Okay, I am back armed with kitchen towel. Colour almost looks stronger on here than it does on the paper. Okay. So, that's the yellow, the fleshy tone. And the pink. Let's go to the orange now. Jeez. I'm so glad I bought other brushes. Yeah, pretty fluorescent. Still a little bit of it in there. Oh, I accidentally pulled out one of the fibers. Okay, now let's move on to the yellow. Oops, didn't clean off the brush enough from the orange there. Easy cleanup actually gives you an idea of what colour it's going to be. Surprisingly bright yellow. Let's keep going through these. So I'm going to... still very slightly contaminated by the orange. Going to pop this one down by the first colour I swatched to see the difference. Difference is that one looks like mango and one looks like lemon. Ooh, maybe I could give these fruit names. I'm not entirely sure what I'd call that one actually, but that's obviously orange. That one would probably be pink grapefruit. Nah, I'm getting ahead of myself. Although maybe one day I can start my own paint company and I will name all of the colours after fruits and vegetables. That could be fun. So, yellow, let's try the red. The red is fairly pinky, but actually it's pretty much the same colour as the brush here, so it's not too bad. Now to start on the greens. Fairly bright. I'd call that a lime. let's go for the medium green. More of a grassy colour, that one. I'm actually going to speed through the rest of these, and if I decide to give any of them a creative name, I'll pop it over here somewhere. So enjoy the rest of the swatches. Colours that I have to work with for this little guy. I am going to give up on using this brush for any painting purposes. I might still use it for mixing up the paint, and this paint comes with clear palette as well, so I will likely end up scooping it into there and then use maybe a couple of these brushes to do the actual painting. So let's get into that. Okay, you couldn't make this stuff up. I went to try and rip into these along the edge of the plastic, and the cheap packaging has just... the cardboard's split in two. I'm not entirely sure how to... Aha! Nails is how to get in. Yeah, they are free! Now then, which one is it that I want to use to start with? Let's start with this yellow one. Which is... Oh, they're really soft! That's great! Actually really looking forward to using these. That's really, really good. So... time to mix up a colour. I should bring my dirty water back in. Now then, if we start off with some of the chocolate brown. Whatever colour I mix up, I'm going to need loads of it, so I really shouldn't be afraid to mess up the brush, because it's going to be used for scooping paint a lot this evening. This could take quite a while. I'll spare you the pain. Finally managed to get enough of the chocolate out there. Now, we're going to go for more of this one. Honestly, I've got no idea how long this is going to take. This could turn into a several evenings job. This is painful. So the change in lighting is because I just realised that you couldn't see the colours that well. So I've just adjusted that, changed which light is on. And hopefully, you'll be able to see a lot better now. So, let's start taking some of this one. Arr. You know what? I said I'd spare you the pain. I'll do that throughout. Okay, I now have the basic colour that I want to start with on the shell. So, I think that I should probably actually start with the bigger brush so that I cover the surface area a lot faster. Wow, these are so soft. I really like these. I can't believe they're only £1.50. Well, they're really good, and if any of you are ever in the works, 5 brushes, £1.50. Really good. Okay. Let's start putting on the base colour. It's quite sandy, which is... It is actually what I was hoping for, a sandy colour. I'm going to treat these kind of like watercolours and add very carefully and slowly in layers. At the moment it's actually kind of looking like I've done one of those tea stains that we all did to make paper look old when we were kids. Okay, I'm not being very neat here. There's no denying that. I'm not being neat. Going outside the lines. But I'm hoping that with details, and then afterwards I'll use a pen to go over things, it actually won't look that bad. Okay, that's the first colour, but now we need it to dry. That's the problem with using paper that's not actually designed for this. I will have to move on to a different colour now, on a different area of the drawing, so that it doesn't get contaminated. Right, let's pop you back in there. Don't know why I was still holding that one. Okay, let's start mixing up the crab colour itself. I've got quite a nice brown in just the chocolate colour here, but I'm going to try and add some of the fluorescent flesh. Honestly, these paints are, I don't know how kids deal with them. Maybe I'm just being really impatient, wanting to be able to get on with my art straight away. And I accidentally put some of the next colour over. Right. Let's put some water in here. I just realised that I missed part of the inside of the shell, so I'll go over that now. There we go. I can build that up with darker tones later on. Let's try taking a drop of the brown and popping it in the fleshy tone. Let's try the other way around. Taking a bit of that and putting it in there. That's looking more like it. I think I'll add some orange in as well. There. That's the colour I was looking for. Great. Day, obviously for you it's only a couple seconds later. I had a really bad day at work, so I'm just gonna not talk now until the outro, so enjoy the painting. days later, and this is the result of my experiment with kids' paint. So, as you can see, you can create half-decent artworks with children's poster paints. But it is worth noting that through doing that particular painting, I am now down to the pan in this sandy colour and pretty much in the chocolate brown. There's a bit of staining to the yellow from where I was mixing, but yes, other than the lack of quantity, these paints seem to do absolutely fine, and the quality of the paper didn't seem to matter either. So that is it from me for now. I will see you again very soon, and we'll be trying more cheap art supplies. See you soon.